This morning in the kitchen, we are cooking with GoProvidence.com, getting tips from the pros. Our pro today is Chef Champe Speidel from Persimmon. Chef, what are we making today?
Today we're going to braise, and braising is a great technique in that you can utilize any cut. We happen to be using lamb neck, which is just like it sounds. It's a very tough cut of meat, but we're going to turn it into something very flavorful and very savory. The tougher the cut, the more savory we can make it when we cook it long and slow in liquid. And we're going to serve that with some, vegetables that are available this time of year and some hand-rolled potato gnocchi.
Nice. And what are the vegetables that we'll be using today? Take us through some of the other ingredients.
We've got some sweet potatoes, some little baby turnips, radish, Brussels sprouts, and we've got some native greens, a little claytonia, and then some petite sprouts.
What is claytonia?
Claytonia is a little wild, very grassy flavored green. You can grow them in a greenhouse about this time of year. Plus, we've got a really nice spring, so it helps.
Excellent.
But it does come up on its own about usually late March, April. You'll see it all around your garden bed. It just sort of lays dormant and then comes about in the spring.
Wow. And would you say that these vegetables, and I know we've got a lot of like the root vegetables here, do those play off well on the flavors that a lamb does?
Absolutely. And plus, they're indicative of the season. And you don't really want to braise something when it's 95 outside.
Right. No.
So we're not going to braise something and serve it with tomatoes.
Mm-hmm.
These are perfect for a hearty dish, a stick to your ribs kind of dish.
Yep.
As I said earlier, we have been warm, but something when it's 20 degrees outside is perfect.
All right, excellent. Well, we'll be cooking it up in just a bit. Back to you. School vacation is a great time for your kids to read a great book. And joining us this morning with her picks for February vacation for reads for all ages is the manager of Barrington Books, Jennifer Masati. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's jump on into our young readers, our 4 through 8 year olds.
Okay. If you're traveling to visit grandparents on this vacation week, Grandpa Green is a great book to bring along. It's about a little boy who's learning about his great-grandfather by walking through the grandfather's topiary garden. It's beautifully illustrated and really touching story. Here we have Me, Jane, which is a story about famous primatologist Jane Goodall.
Mm-hmm.
And it's beautifully illustrated and written by the same illustrator and author. And it has some information in here about...
Look at that picture.
Isn't that great?
Charming. Oh my gosh.
So they can learn about Jane Goodall as well, as it's a great story.
And become
story.
Jealous that she got to play with the chimps.
Right, exactly. For the middle of early readers, Bink and Golly, about two children who are very different but still the very best of friends. It's fabulously illustrated and it's just a fun read.
And this one is a chapter book for
chapter
beginning
book.
Chapter
exactly.
readers.
Exactly.
All right, and for 9 through 12 year olds, what do you have?
9 through 12, Wonderstruck. It's the second book by the author of The Invention of Hugo Cabret, which
was a movie.
Was the movie. And it's also written in that graphic novel
that's
style.
So, fun, yeah.
So this one follows two characters. The main character, Rose's story, is depicted all in pictures, and then the second character, Ben, is all in words. So it's a huge book, but a great read. It's something. It's a great book to tackle on this big long vacation.
Yeah, keep those kids busy.
Right, right. Dead End here.
Mm-hmm.
This one is a Newbery Honor Award winner, which is the highest award a children's book can be given. And a lot of our customers that come into Barrington Books are looking for suggestions for books for boys to read, especially in this age group. So this one appeals to both boys and girls. And it's slightly autobiographical about the author. It's a coming-of-age tale, and it's just a wonderful book.
Well, speaking of coming-of-age, what do you have for our teenagers, 13 through 17-year-olds who definitely need something to do during this week off?
Everything is sci-fi, fantasy.
Mm-hmm.
We have a couple of selections here. Beautiful Chaos. This is actually the third in a series of four. And this, fans of Twilight will absolutely love this. Our staff that has read the series think this is,
the next Twilight?
Better than Twilight.
Oh, Team Jacob, Team Edward, Team Beautiful Chaos. There you go. And I know that you also brought along some projects. So if the kids want to take a break from the reading, and if the parents, if we have some rain coming up, if they need to keep them busy indoors, what did you bring?
We have create your own pop-up books. We have tie-dye kits. Make your own kites. We have lots of activities for to keep them busy during this school vacation week.
Nice, and keep the creativity as well as the reading going. We want to keep those brains going along. Well, thank you so much, Jennifer,
for all these wonderful
ideas, and to help keep your kids active this week, and to get all of these titles mentioned, and also for these cool kits, just head to WPRI.com. All week long, students across the Ocean State are celebrating school vacation. So we decided to get the scoop from local teens on everything from dates, drugs, and future goals. Take a look. Today in Teen Talk, we're discussing the issues with four local high school students from all across the Ocean State. But first, we want you to get to know them better.
Hey, I'm Maddie. I'm a junior at the Wheeler School. I'm 17. My family and my friends are really important to me. I love photography and I'm a big soccer player.
Hi, my name's Tess. I'm 17 and a senior at LaSalle Academy. I love cheerleading, reading, and I hope to travel all around the world someday.
I'm Brooke. I'm 15. I'm a sophomore at West Warwick High School. I'm a family-oriented girl and I really love music.
Hi everyone, my name is Alex Denoncourt. I'm from Johnston High School. I'm 16 and I'm a junior. I'm a three-sport athlete. I play football, baseball, and basketball, and I also perform in the drama club.
We want to get to know you a little better, so where are you from? I mean, give us the rundown. What do you like to do?
I love cheerleading. I also have a younger sister. We do cheerleading together, so that's a good time. We're pretty much best friends.
I'm in the drama club, and I do the spring cabaret and then the winter musical that we do. And I'm in the Honor Society for music, and I'm in student council too.
My grades really do come first. I'm in all honors classes in the National Honor Society.
Wow.
But I really like to play sports. I play basketball, baseball, and football.
I'm really into photography, and also soccer. Soccer's my favorite sport. And other things like part of the peer support program at Wheeler. So what we do is it's juniors and seniors, so this is my first year on it. We work a lot with the ninth graders because it's their first year in high school. So that's really important to me.
So tell me about your family. I mean, brothers and sisters, what's the dynamic like?
I have two sisters, Alina and Laura. Alina's close to my age, she's 18, uh-huh. And Laura's 22.
How are you, man?
I have one younger sister.
Okay.
She's 13. We have a good family dynamic. My larger, more extended family is also really important to me.
I live with my mom, and I have a three-year-old brother. His name's Jake, and we're really close. He's a little Terra. But he's so cute, and I'm getting him really involved in music, which is exciting to me because, since we're 12 years apart,
uh-huh.
So, you know, when I'm older, hopefully he'll do school plays and stuff, and I'll get to come.
What about you, Seth?
I have one younger sister. Her name's Maddie. She's a sophomore. We're pretty much best friends. If we do get in a fight, we will make up 5 minutes later. We fight over pretty harmless things, small things, who took whose headband, but we'll kiss and make up 5 minutes later.
All right, so you guys are involved in a lot of different sports and clubs. What organizations are you involved in? We want to know.
I work a lot. I work at Town Hall Lane's Bowling Center.
Okay.
And I bowled for 10 years, so then they just hired me on.
No, my friends are really important to me. Mm-hmm. In the winter, because I don't play winter sport, me and two of my friends, we go to a CrossFit Providence, which is it's a gym. It's hard to explain what it is, but it's just this kind of workout regimen that we do. So we do that for the winter.
I hang out with my grandmother all the time. She's my best friend. We go on shopping dates. We go to Newport for the day. We go to dinner. We have sleepovers. She's my best friend.
Me and this girl, Vicky, we grew Greek dance together, so kind of like those big Greek dances you see in the movies or see on TV. That's what we do. That really happens.
So now that you know our teens, we'll be talking to them throughout the week about various issues that arise in high school. You can read more about the teens by heading to our website at WPRI.com.
Still to come this morning on The Road Show, are you still trying to get into a fitness routine? Star of Style Network's hit show Wicked Fit is here with workout tips for us.
Plus, in today's Modern Parent, we learn about the importance of being a mentor.
You're watching The Road Show, and we're back in 90 seconds.
The Road Home on The Road Show is brought to you by Cardi's Furniture, offering same-day text-ahead mattress eye delivery 7 days a week. For locations and to shop online, visit Cardi's.com.
Right now at Cardi's Furniture, get Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America, with no interest till 2016. Tempur-Pedic mattresses automatically react to your body's weight, shape, and temperature,
which provides unsurpassed comfort and therapeutic support.
Save $200 on Tempur-Pedic Ergo bases
and see why Tempur-Pedic owners are more satisfied than owners of any traditional mattress brand.
Cardi's Furniture and Mattresses.
Why should you take your family to see America's most beloved characters from everyone's favorite street? Because there's nothing like seeing Sesame Street live. Do something good for your family and make a memory that will last a lifetime. Experience Sesame Street Live, coming to a stage near your neighborhood.
Call 421 Arts now for Sesame Street Live, March 9th through the 11th at PPAC.
Now that I have insurance, I can call her doctor.
With Assurance Wireless, you get a free cell phone plus 250 free voice minutes each month.
Now that we have Assurance, we can keep in touch with our grandchildren.
You also get nationwide coverage and these calling features with no annual contract. Plus, it's easy to keep your current number.
To see if you qualify, call 1-800-378-7318. That's 1-800-378-7318. Or visit assurancewireless.com.
Today in Project Fitness, many of us made the New Year's resolution to lose weight, but now that a few weeks have passed, it's time to get back on track. And joining us is star of Style Network's hit show, Wicked Fit, personal trainer Katie Boyd from the Misfit Club with tips on how to keep up with your resolution. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, so you were telling me before that I know so many people make these resolutions, but it's not just on New Year's Day. You can pretty much do it whenever you can.
Right. I think what people do, the biggest mistake is they're like, okay, January 1st, it's time. And you know what? It's time when it's time for you. And I think that's what people do. They set themselves up to really fail by boxing them into a time constraint. Mm-hmm. So I say, when you're ready to do the fitness thing, then that's when it's time to do it.
All right, for those of us who have been trying to keep up as much as we can, I know sometimes it's hard to stay motivated and right. to maybe lose those few extra pounds mm-hmm. at this point. What do you tell them?
I say definitely get a gym buddy. You know, okay. personal training is a huge luxury. Mm-hmm. We all know that. And it can be very expensive, but if you have a gym buddy, that person's going to be waiting at the gym, or you're going to be waiting for that person, so you're more apt to work out when you have that pressure of having someone there waiting. And obviously, nutrition is 80% of the game.
Okay.
If you're not eating the right things, you can work out till the cows come home, you can have 10 gym buddies, but it's all about what you're putting in your mouth. So I say, make sure you have protein with each meal, so, you know, eggs or chicken or fish or even peanut butter or edamame and things like that with every meal, and try to eat 5 times a day. And after lunch, try to cut the carbs out. So people say, oh, that's so hard because I crave fruit or something like that. So my favorite thing is tribe hummus. It's like an amazing nice. Snack after lunch. Mm-hmm. Have that with a ton of vegetables, but just lay off the carrots and the tomatoes because they're very starchy carbs. Okay. People don't know that. Everybody's like, oh, I had like 20 tomatoes today. I'm like, good for you. You just pretty much ate the calories and the carbohydrates of a Snickers bar.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so that's a big, big, big mistake. And also just at dinner, make sure that you just have carbs and protein. So like, you know, a boatload of asparagus and a chicken breast, and just put yourself to sleep. And if you're hungry after that, it's usually because you're thirsty. Have a cup of tea.
All right. Now we want to talk about your show called Wicked Fit. Hmm. Millions of viewers are watching this. So how has this experience been for you?
The experience has, it's like having a baby. So you know when you say like you have your first baby and you're like, that was so much pain, I will never do that again. And then like a couple of years later you have like 5 more children.
Right.
It's the same thing. You know, while you're doing it, it's so tiring and it takes so much work. And you know, I have 2 businesses and it was really tough because I had to put those businesses aside, which was sad for me because I love what I do.
Yeah.
But it was an awesome experience, and now, you know, I really want to be a role model all over the world for girls that, you know, struggle with weight issues, because I have struggled with my weight mm-hmm. my whole entire life, and I competed in pageants, so I had that extra added pressure.
Yeah.
And I have girls from all over the country now, all over the world, because it's crazy. Style is all over the world. It's in Australia, UK, Dubai. I mean, we get letters every day from people in South Africa that want me to come there and do seminars. So I really, what I want to do is just be a good role model for girls all over the, and guys all over the world.
I think you're doing just that. And we want to thank you, Katie, so much
for
joining us today. You can catch Katie on Style Network's Wicked Fit 2nd season starting this summer. And to get all these tips and more, visit our website, WPRI.com.
Today in The Modern Parent, are you searching for a way to better the world or possibly better yourself? Well, have you ever thought about being a mentor? Mentors help to develop a child's self-esteem and confidence. So we went to Children's Workshop to learn more.
How would you like to share your expertise and skills with a child? By spending some quality time as a mentor, you may be able to be a positive change in their lives. The Children's Workshop says that students who have mentors have a desire to stay in school, and believe that they can be whatever they want to be.
Mentoring is a wonderful program where adults can come out and share their experiences, provide support, be a positive role model to young children, and it can range from elementary all the way up to high school.
Children's Workshop says that when a child has a mentor, they're more likely to participate in class and get involved with school activities. There are two different types of mentoring, which allow you the ability to find one that fits your schedule and lifestyle.
One is school-based mentoring, and what that consists of is the mentee and mentor meet at the school. They usually do a one-on-one mentoring session. It usually lasts a school calendar year, but everything remains right there on the school grounds, so it's a little more structured. And then we have community-based mentoring, and that is a very flexible way to do some mentoring. You can go out into the community, you can go out to ball games, you can go to the movies, you can do all this fun stuff with your mentor. So it's a little different, and it can be more than 1 hour a week. It can be a few hours, whatever your schedule allows for with the mentee mentor.
In addition to enjoying working with kids, there are a few other important qualities for a mentor.
We want that person to be committed, to say that, yes, I'm going to work with that mentee for a year. So that child knows that they have you there and they can trust in you and feel comfortable with you. You have to be dependable, reliable. You need to be fun-loving to work with kids.
If you're interested in becoming a mentor, have no fear. Most mentoring programs have ongoing training sessions to help coach you and give you ideas. Some mentors play sports, others play board games, but above all, mentors just need to be positive and supportive role models.
Some great ways to get involved is we're very lucky in Rhode Island that we have Rhode Island Mentoring Partnership out there, and you can go on the web and look them up, you can give them a call, and what they do is they'll hook you up with the type of mentoring you'd like to do. If you want to do one-on-one mentoring, if you want to do group mentoring, they even have, you can go on the web and do web mentoring, where you can just do it back and forth with email. So there's great ways to get involved in mentoring. If you have skills, if you're good, you know, with the educational piece, come out. If you're good with the social piece, that you're great interacting with kids, come out and do that. There's plenty of ways to get involved in the mentoring program.
In addition to benefits for the child, being a mentor can be great for you too. The Children's Workshop says that mentors are happier when they return to work, feel a great sense of satisfaction, and have a greater understanding of today's youth. They also say that mentors report they even have a better relationship with their own families, thanks to the relationships they build with their mentee. So if you're interested in learning how to become a mentor, head to our website, WPRI.com.
Still to come this morning on The Road Show, we'll be back in the kitchen with Persimmon Restaurant making braised lamb neck. You can find the recipe right now at WPRI.com.
And a new phobia is on the rise, and it could affect you. We're talking about the fear of losing your phone. That's next in The Buzz.
Living healthy on The Road Show is made possible by South Coast Smiles. Comfortable, convenient, beautiful dentistry. Call today and we'll see you within 24 hours.
We're here at Countrywide Gold Buyers, the most trusted gold buyer in Rhode Island. We're here to find out what makes Countrywide Gold Buyers the best place to sell your gold and silver.
Selling your gold and silver to us is simple and without mystery. We weigh and test everything in front of you, and within minutes, you'll have your money. Bring us anything that is gold or silver, broken, outdated jewelry, silverware, coins, or anything else you might have.
Just visit any of our safe and reputable locations. Bristol, Warren, Providence Place Mall, Warwick Mall, Cranston, and South County Commons.
Mom? I hear you're having a tough day, so I brought you a freshly made sandwich.
You made me a sandwich?
No, Duncan did, but I wrote the note.
Try Duncan's sandwich combo. A bakery sandwich and a small iced coffee or iced tea, just $3.99. America runs on Duncan.
If you've had vaginal mesh surgery to repair pelvic problems or incontinence, the vaginal mesh may cause future pain, infection, and more. The FDA has issued a warning. Lawsuits have been filed, and some victims have received monetary settlements. If you've had vaginal mesh surgery, call the law offices of Rob Levine at 1-800-529-2999 to see if you qualify. There is no charge to evaluate your case. Vaginal mesh surgery complications can be dangerous, so call Rob Levine today at 1-800-529-2999 before your time runs out.
They were made for each other. They're like the perfect match.
Brad and Jill in accounting. Crazy.
Coffee and chocolate.
Mocha.
Ooh. Who's Mocha?
For the perfect blend of coffee and chocolate, try a Mocha coffee or latte today. America runs on Dunkin'. You're watching The Road Show on WPRI 12.
Welcome back to The Road Show. We all do it constantly, check our cell phones between new emails, Facebook updates, text messages, and tweets, not to mention all those apps. There is a lot to keep up with. But are you actually afraid to be without your phone? If so, you could be suffering from nomophobia. Yes, it is real. It's the fear of being without your phone, and studies show it's on the rise. An online polling system found that 66% of people in the UK are afraid of losing or being without their phone. Survey also found that females fear of losing their phone more than males, but men are more likely to have multiple phones. Adults 18 to 24 tend to be the most nomophobic, followed by those 25 to 34. Mm-hmm. There they are. Are you nomophobic?
You know, I never even thought of this fear until now, and I think I have it.
Oh, I am.
Oh, no.
My life is in my smartphone.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Contact, I don't think I can tell you anyone's number other than my immediate family. You know, the ones that you have been calling before you even had a cell phone.
Right. Yep.
I don't think I could tell you any of my friends' cell phone numbers. I'm sorry, guys. but they're all in there. Your emails, our calendars. I mean,
everybody's
especially
life
we're always on the go. Not just us, everyone in general now. Their life is, you know, in the palm of your hand.
I clutch this phone like it's my third child.
Right
after they created fire, this was the second greatest invention.
Yeah.
There are times I have this at my feet down here, and there sometimes people will send text messages or something. It takes everything in me not to pick up that phone while we're here to sit here and read what's going on. Absolutely, I have it.
I think, you know, I definitely during the work week and everything, I mean, you're held accountable to have your phone, but I like the vacation from the nomophobia. Mm-hmm. I like to leave my phone. I like to have those weekends where I turn it off, and it is hard that first hour.
Yep.
You sit there and you're like, what am I going to do with all my time? I can't go on Facebook or Twitter or do what I need to do. I like those breaks, though.
Mm-hmm. I agree. I think I suffer from something, too, where I have my phone on vibrate many times rather than a ring or something like that, and I feel like it's going off.
Yeah.
Yep.
And did it just go? And I'll check.
Like,
no, nothing happened.
So
you
feel
when it doesn't, it's a mental thing. You think you feel it vibrate, or you think you hear it going off, and you like run to hurry and check in. You're going, what is wrong with me? Am I losing my mind slowly? Probably.
I have forgotten the phone at home and turned the car around and gone back to get the phone because I'm in such a panic of being without the phone.
Well, I used to be so proud of myself before all these touch screens, you know, the regular keys that you had to push. I used to be the master at that, and my friends would time me and I'd sit there and not even need to look and I'd text to them. And now with this touch screen, I think that's what's throwing me for the loop. I don't like the touch screen as much, so that's why I like to put it away a little bit.
And there's nothing worse when you go away someplace or hit a spot where there's no network. You go into like panic mode.
Service,
I'm the most important person and I need to be contacted, because I don't have my network with me.
Sometimes, too, even when I'm just running down the road to grab something at the market or drop something off, mail or whatever, and I leave it at home, it's slight panic going, this is going to be the one time that I break down or something happens or someone's calling me with an emergency. So it's just that mental thing. You know, you're going a minute away.
Yep.
You're going to be gone for maybe 5 minutes.
Yep.
But it's, what if something happens in that 5 minutes that I just need to get in touch with?
Or the worst is if you leave it somewhere that's not home or your car. I mean, that's when the real panic jumps in. You know, if you leave it at home or your car, you think, all right, I'm going to be okay. But if you're going through your purse and you are just at five different places and you don't know where it is, that's when you want to cry.
Suri has become my girlfriend. Just don't tell my wife.
I won't. However, she's here today.
Yes,
so I don't know if that's
I've ratted myself out. There are a lot of people who, though, I think suffer from this, panic, right?
It's
I wonder if they're going to admit to it.
Yeah.
So I know our Facebook and our Twitter friends have been posting things. And Mary, what's everyone saying
today? Probably posting while they were on their phones, to be honest. Leslie Kostick says, if I accidentally leave it and head to work without it, I turn around and go back home to get it.
She's
I'm with you.
Even if that means I'm late to work, it's become a security blanket.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Lori Arlen Grant says, no, I don't. No news is good news. Way to go, Lori. Brendan Cox says, I take my phone to school and to the store or when I'm out with my friends. I just want a way to communicate with my parents. I'm not afraid of being without it. It's just a little safer, and that's my only way to communicate with my parents.
That's so true.
Gotta be safe. Taking it from a kid's perspective, especially since it's vacation week. So you too can vote by in today's poll. Do you think you have nomophobia? Yes, I can't be without my phone. Or no, I could live without it. And here's a look at some other topics that are trending online today. Daniel Radcliffe may no longer be playing a wizard, but he still has some tricks up his sleeve. While promoting his latest movie, The Woman in Black, the star decided to show off his ability to fold his tongue into one loop, a second loop, and a third loop. Wow. Can any of you at home do this? Talk about magical. We all know that sharing is caring, and the philosophy is now shared by animals as well. Here's a video going viral around the web showing a little bird feeding his furry friend some spaghetti noodles. Aww, so cute. Malaysian artist Hong Yi, better known as Red, has shared her newest art project with the World Wide Web. Her first big hit was when she was painting a picture of NBA basketball player Yao Ming with a basketball. Red's current hit shows her using the bottom of a coffee cup as a paintbrush. She said the project was inspired by Hao Chu's song Secret, in which the first line talks about lifting up a coffee cup off the saucer. So I'm going to have to try this at home with my cup of Dunkin'. And I'll be back at the end of the show with your poll results. For now, back to the kitchen, Will.
Thanks, Mary. We are back in the Roadshow kitchen this morning with Chef Champe Speidel. And we are making, we're going to make lamb, right?
Correct. Lamb neck. We're going to braise it.
And we're going to braise it this morning. And for a lot of people who aren't familiar with how to braise it, you are our guy. You're going to show us how to do all the braising.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's get to it.
Well, anytime you braise something, you're dealing with a tough cut of meat.
Okay.
You want to sear the outside because we're going to cook it in liquid, so we want to get some caramelization. So you just start with a little oil in a regular saute pan. Now you can either start in the pan that you're going to braise in, which we're going to do, or you can do them separate if you're doing a big batch and then put them into a bigger pot into the oven, and you can forget about it for a couple hours.
Now, what does this pan have to be on? I mean, does it got to be on a real high heat?
Yeah.
Real high heat.
Not
okay.
super high, but we
right.
do want a little bit of smoke so we know we're going to get some caramelization.
Okay.
We're going to season them. So a little bit of salt.
Now, you know, some people have a fear of, you know, lamb. A lot of Middle Eastern people cook with lamb. What am I looking for when I am going to the butcher to get, to get lamb?
Well, you came to the right place. First of all, I am a butcher, and we have a butcher shop
Look
as well.
Look at this. All in one. You are our guy.
So we're really helping out today. But what you're looking for, you want to trust your butcher, number one.
Mm-hmm.
You're looking for a good marble, obviously.
Right.
This is the neck piece, so it obviously gets a lot of work.
Sure.
The more work it does, the more flavor. Each time we break down these little pieces of sinew in here, we're going to extract gelatin.
Okay.
The collagen in this meat's going to break down. We're going to extract the gelatin. That's that lip-smacking flavor you're looking for in a good
right.
braise. That's what we're after. So the more marbling, the intramuscular fat, you see, that's going to help the dish.
And when we are braising, how long are we going to leave this on each side to
We want to get a good color. So you can see right now, haven't got a good color yet. That
right.
looks gray. We want it to turn brown. So it takes about 2 minutes a side.
Right.
Okay. We're going to sear each side, turn the heat up a little bit more.
Okay.
And then we're going to cover it with liquid.
Right. And let it simmer.
Good. You really want to use the best stock right. you can. This is a lamb stock.
Okay.
If you don't have lamb stock, you can use chicken stock.
All right, so we are going to continue the braising process here, and in the meantime, back to you.
All right, still to come this morning on the Roadshow, the CBS hit series Unforgettable has a new cast member. We're talking to Jane Curtin and Poppy Montgomery about the show. Plus, taking care of yourself doesn't just mean eating right and working out. We'll tell you how dental care plays a major role in your health. You're watching the Roadshow. We're back in just 90 seconds.
Tips from the Pros is presented by GoProvidence.com, your one stop for what's going on in Providence and beyond.
Call South Coast Smiles today and we'll see you within 24 hours.
Comfortable, convenient, beautiful dentistry. Just ask our patients.
They changed my smile and it changed my life.
Dentist helped me have a nice big smile.
They took the time to clearly explain the importance of dental health.
Get experienced dental care you can trust and afford. And for fearful patients, we offer sedation dentistry. Visit MySouthCoastSmiles.com today. Relax. Dentistry is easy here.
Donna, Mike, hi, how are you guys?
Hey, Lori, we're fantastic.
Hey, you guys went on that cruise that you won here at Twin River last year, right?
Yes, we did. It was amazing. Why do you ask?
Because it's that time of year again, and we're giving away cruises all month long.
This February, rid those winter blues and win a Norwegian cruise again at Twin River. Earn entries all month while you play. And every Friday, 25 lucky guests can win a Norwegian cruise for two.
We packed our bags. We're ready to go.
We sure are.
Looks like we'll see you on Friday, then.
Twin River Casino. So much, so close, so rewarding.
Wow, are you seeing this? You've got them wrapped around your finger. Last Minute Laboratory guy, Sudoku lady, all of them. It's got to be those new frames. I bet their electronic devices are off too.
find your look with Fishing World selection, service, and prices. Now get two complete pairs just $99 or two pairs of no-line bifocals for $179. Fishing World.
That works.
Unforgettable has become a hit show on CBS and is now introducing a new character and a well-known actress to the cast. Joining us is the show's star, Poppy Montgomery, along with Jane Curtin. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for being here with us this morning.
It's a pleasure. How is Providence this morning?
Providence is great. We, the weather's nice. All is good here in the city.
Yeah. I went to high school in Rhode Island.
You did? Where did you go to high school?
It's no longer in existence. It was a boarding school in Newport.
Oh, that's great to know. So you're almost a local girl.
I am.
and I know that you grew up in Cambridge, Mass, right?
Uh-huh.
So you know the area very well. Well, first, let's say thanks for being on with us this morning. Congratulations on the show. It's great to have you with us here today.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Okay, Poppy, if I can start out with you. I saw you on Letterman just a few weeks ago. When you came out with the red hair and everything else, I don't think Dave knew what to say.
I didn't know what to say. He's David Letterman. I was in awe, and it was a really fun, experience for me. After I got through my nerves and terror, I actually really enjoyed just talking to him, and he's extraordinarily funny and witty and sharp and all of those things. But it was a great time for me.
And you were talking about funny and witty, so is the lady sitting next to you. How great
yes.
is that to be working with her?
It's extraordinary. It's such a gift. And when we found out that she had agreed to do the show, it was a real celebration. She's amazing. And
and she makes
and she
you laugh.
She brings this enormous life and light and energy to the show, which is so important, I think.
Okay, for those people who haven't seen the show, can you just give us a little background on what the show is about?
Well, gosh, where do I begin? I play a detective, Carrie Wells. I have a very unique ability, which is that I can basically remember everything. And I join the Queen's Homicide to help solve crimes. And Jane is our medical examiner, and her and I become a sort of team, if you will. It looks like it's going in that direction. And, you know, it's sort of a twist on the classic crime drama. It's almost superhero-ish, you know, the ability that my character has. And there's romance, and there's chemistry between us all, and it's a great group. It's a great team.
And basically, I mean, for those who don't know, it's basically the same thing that Mary Lou Henner has, where she doesn't forget anything.
That's right. She actually has, I mean, we've taken some creative license with this ability, but Mary Lou Henner has the real version of it, which is a highly superior autobiographical memory. Can you believe I can remember
Look
to say that?
Look at that. You are good. You are very
great
good.
Memory.
She does. Jane, you've done, you know, so many comedies. You've won two Emmys, some of the classic shows of the 80s. You were in 80s and 90s. Is it a lot different working on a drama than it was a comedy?
It's for a crime drama, yes, because so much has to be spent on the crime, because that's why people tune in, and so your character develops over time, so you don't really know exactly who you are until the end of the season, and everything has been introduced that defines you.
I also heard that the show was shot on location in New York City. Now, we all know how New Yorkers can be. Has it been great doing the show live in New York?
Well, we're doing it in Queens and the environs. And New Yorkers are fabulous. I mean, there was some survey that said New Yorkers were the rudest. I take issue with that. And I think New Englanders are far more rude than I'm a New Englander. You take that Amtrak boy and nobody's going to give up a seat.
That is true.
But New Yorkers are, no, they're gruff, but they're very warm.
They are. They are very warm.
Well, ladies, thank you so much for being on with us today. We appreciate it. Jane, if you're ever in Rhode Island, we would love to have you sit here on the Roadshow couch with us. It would be great to have both of you ladies here.
I love Rhode Island.
And thank you.
You are very welcome. You can catch up on Unforgettable Tuesday nights right here on WPRI 12.
Still to come this morning on The Road Show, we are back in the kitchen. And don't forget, you can cook along with us at WPRI.com. We'll be right back.
The Modern Parent on The Road Show is brought to you by The Children's Workshop, where learning is child's play. For more info, log on to childrensworkshop.com.
Hear that? That's your vacation calling. It's time for AAA Travel Marketplace, the biggest travel show of the year. Everyone's going to be there, offering trips to warm places and really cool ones. Book your best vacation ever. AAA Travel Marketplace is open to everyone, and the parking is free. See you March 2nd, 3rd, and 4th at Gillette Stadium, Putnam Club East.
Allergy season.
Good thing it's Allegra season. I bought it at Walmart without a prescription.
Allegra gives you fast, non-drowsy, 24-hour relief of your toughest symptoms. Get Allegra at an everyday low price at Walmart.
Get ready. They're coming. And now they're snapping to a whole new beat. When you're an Adams. The Addams Family is now a drop-dead hilarious Broadway musical starring the family you know so well in a brand new story you won't believe. Wednesday's in love, Gomez is in trouble, and you're in for the musical comedy event of the season.
Coming to PPAC March 20th through 25th. Snap up your tickets at PPACRI.org, sponsored by Coastway Community Bank.
President Bree.
Oh, no, I can't say. Oh,
so creamy. So delicious. It will leave your friends speechless.
Great party.
President Bree, leave your friends speechless.
Yours was a normal pregnancy, but your child has cerebral palsy, and now the doctor won't give you answers. I'm attorney Jim Sokloff. If your child has CP, call us. And if you have a case, we'll make our 24-hour promise. Within 24 hours, we'll start working to get money for your child's care. Call my firm, because we're the legal veterans who for over 30 years have held doctors accountable. For our 24-hour promise, call Sokoloff Law at 1-800-CALL-JIM.
All right, cooking along with GoProvidence.com, getting tips from the pros today in the kitchen. Chef Champe Speidel is here. We are cooking up that braised lamb neck. Did I get it right?
Correct.
Okay.
We've seared the outside. We've got our caramelization, which we were going for. We're going to add some vegetables to cook along with it, some carrots.
Okay.
Some parsnips, which give a nice sweetness.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to necessarily eat these later. They're just going to infuse the broth.
Just for a little flavor, right?
Exactly.
Oh, that's nice.
We're going to, you know, we used a nice lamb stock. If you don't have lamb stock, you can use chicken stock.
Mm-hmm.
If you're desperate, you can do water, because you're going to create your own sauce later on. Now, we want to cover these completely, so if you don't have enough stock, cover it with water. Because you don't want
them.
You don't want the outside to dry out. If it dries out, then it's going to be tough.
Okay.
Now, you do want to get this in the oven.
Okay.
And what is our oven set to?
I like to set it for about 325.
Okay.
If you go too hot, it's going to boil and the meat's actually going to toughen. So you want to keep it low, just below a simmer in the oven, 2.5-3 hours, and what's going to happen?
Okay. So nice slow cook.
Exactly.
And it didn't take you very long to even braise that, correct?
Well, 2.5-3
hours. Yeah, 2.5-3 hours. Okay.
Right.
All right.
And this is what you're going to get. Now, you do have to pick the meat off that bone. You don't want to really eat around the bone.
All right. Oh, so what you get,
see all this meat in here, which is finely shredded, very tender.
Apart.
Oh, wow.
Now, we actually added some lamb sausage that we made with some other trimmings.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got lamb neck, we've got lamb sausage, and then add some other fun stuff that will really make this a hearty dish.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Some potato gnocchi, which we made. That's another show, learning how to make your own pasta. But these are potato gnocchi.
Okay.
They're very simple to make. They're delicious, easy. Mm-hmm. You can make them ahead of time. We actually make them. And then you can freeze
them. Toss
those
in.
All right, so you got that.
Okay. There's
some Brussels sprouts here.
And this is great because you're just throwing everything into the same container,
so
the same pot.
No mess. Technically a one-pot dish. You can bring this to the table. You can do it family style. You can serve it individually if you'd like.
I love that. Easy cleanup for everyone at home.
Little baby turnips.
Ooh,
so again, some nice vegetables, just so it doesn't get redundant with just lamb.
Right.
You want to freshen it up.
Okay.
Sweet potato, a little extra sweetness. We've just diced these, cooked them ahead of time. Some radishes.
Nice.
Okay. Ooh.
We warm all this up.
Radish in here.
I don't think I use
radish enough in my recipe.
And I like radish too.
Radishes are delicious.
Yeah,
you can almost get them year round. A lot of people with greenhouses grow them, especially around here, which is important. So we don't have to bring everything in from California.
Right.
Yeah.
And again, you want something a little bit different, so a little bite of turnip, a little bite of radish, mm-hmm. a little softness of the gnocchi. The gnocchi, you see these little dimples? They'll pick up the sauce.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay, they'll sit right in there.
Okay.
Nice.
Let's
finish it
with a little bit of nice parsley, which will brighten it up.
Looks good.
Wow.
Our little bitter, in sort of spring-like, grassy claytonia.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I've ever had that either.
And I know you were talking about the radish.
Yeah. This is the only experience.
There you go, give it a shot.
There you go.
And here we go.
Oh, it's good.
Oh, I like that.
Normally,
I'm
just
throwing that in my salad.
Yeah, normally, like I said, it comes up in spring. It's the first green thing you see. And as a cook, you get really excited by it right after a long New England winter.
Yeah, it seems like a lot of these things you can find year-round. I know you're talking about the radishes, but a lot of these, I mean, they're available all the time.
Absolutely. They're easy to get. Brussels sprouts are available after the first frost. You know, mm-hmm. a lot of people will store those. So, you know, none of this is hard to get. And if you don't have lamb neck, do lamb shank or lamb shoulder or beef shoulder.
And you would still prepare it,
braise
it the same way?
It's a technique. You know, you don't want to just follow a recipe. If you can't get lamb, you can braise pork.
Okay.
You can braise beef.
Because some people hear, you know, some people hear lamb and they get, you know, they get panicky.
Sure.
They don't want to, you know, they don't want to taste it.
Think of a veal ossobuco, the shank, the classic dish. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what we're doing there. And you have to cook it for about 2.5-3 hours, keep it covered in liquid. There's a few more steps involved, but for the sake of time, you know, this is going to be your final dish. You can see the recipe on the website.
Okay. All right,
so we'll give this a taste and scoop that in there.
Take this up. I'm going to give it a little bit of fresh cracked pepper. Pardon me.
Okay.
Okay, while you're doing that, the Legarry family's here. They've been in here this morning.
Let's
so come
bring
on
them
in.
All in.
All right, guys.
Come on in, my friend.
Come on in, guys.
There you go. You can stand right here.
We'll have you
you
try
can do the
it.
First taste.
Come on in, kids.
Get the first
you
taste.
Scoop,
and get a couple forks out.
Bring you over here. There we go.
Here we go. Here we go. Who's giving it a try?
Let's give it a little more broth. How about that? Oh,
yeah.
All right.
Oh, we're all going to try it. All right.
While we're trying, you're going to toss to Mary. So all you got to do is look right in that camera and say,
"That's you, Mary."
That's a boy. See?